If you have a website you like to want to give your visitors an option to contact you directly from your site, you can do that easily by adding a contact form so that visitors, customers, clients, or even potential partners can get in touch with you when they need help or when they have something to share with you. In just four simple steps, I will show you how to create a contact form like this, where anyone can fill out their name, email, and message, and then whenever they click submit, you will get an instant notification in your email inbox. I am Lennart from WP Staging. Let's get started. To increase your motivation to build a good contact form, I'd like to show you four good reasons why you should have a contact form on your website for your visitors. It looks professional. Having a clean and clear contact form makes your website look more professional. A displayed email address doesn't quite have the same effect. The contact form shows that you're organized and have invested time in your website. It reduces spam. Putting an email address out on the internet is basically asking for spam. Hiding your email address by using a contact form makes it harder for spammers to find you. It's easier for the user and keeps them there. A contact form allows visitors to stay on your site. Only posting an email address requires the visitor to open their email client, copy and paste your email address, and then write the message there. And it gets you more leads. When you run a business, you want to get more leads. Leads are a big reason why you need a contact form. In addition to the increased effort of manually writing an email, there's also the fact that if visitors use a public or shared computer, they may not be able to create an email at all. Contact forms and their professional appearance help you to get more leads. They are comfortable, faster, and your visitor can use them from any device. If you like the video, I'd appreciate it if you give me a quick thumbs up. Step number one is installing a contact form plugin. We are going to use a plugin named Contact Form by WP Forms. It's straightforward and easy to set up. To do this, go to the plugins menu tab from the WordPress dashboard and click Add New. Enter WP Forms in the search box. First up is Contact Forms by WP Forms, drag and drop form builder for WordPress. Click on Installation, wait a few seconds, and activate the plugin directly by clicking on Activate. Once it's activated, you will see this dashboard where it says Welcome to WP Forms. The next step is to create a new form. You can go down here to create your first form, and you can also come over to the menu at the left whenever you need to create a new contact form. Go to WP Forms and click Add New. First, just give it a name. I'm just going to say WP Staging Contact Form. Then you can select a template from here, but you can also start from a blank form, which means that there are no fields there. We are going to do the simple contact form. This is a template that you can use, and you see that all of the main fields you might need for a simple contact form are already here. You can click on any of these to make any changes. For instance, I prefer to do a simple format with just one line for a name. And you see that you can make all of these fields required or not by clicking on required. You can even change what the field says by clicking on label and then changing it. If you have another field that you want to add, you can just click on it and then it will drop down. Then you can left click and drag this wherever you want. So I'm going to remove that because I think that the simple contact form works fine. Finally, you can also change the submit button a little bit by clicking on it. And it will come to this area where we can change the button text. By clicking the submit field, we landed in the general area in the settings menu. We can just go to notifications because the next thing we want to do is setting up notifications. That means where does the email goes and what is in the email. By default, the notification gets sent to the admin email, which means the email I use to sign up for WordPress. You can remove that and add your preferred email here, and this can be any email, whether it's your Gmail or Yahoo address. If you want to send it to multiple emails because more than one person in the team should get notified, then you can do that as well. Just do a comma and then add the other email addresses. We set up the notifications, just click Save. The confirmation message is what your visitor sees when they submit the contact form to you. Right now it says, "Thanks for contacting us. We will be in touch with you shortly." You can change this to handle their expectations. If you know it takes you or your support 48 hours to respond, you can mention that. Or you could add your name to personalize the message. You can either display the message, show a specific page on your website, or redirect the visitor to a different URL. But I'm just going to leave the confirmation type as message. Click on Save and then click on the X. You can see the newly created contact form. Step number 3 is to add this form to your page. First, we need to create a contact page, so let's just go up to Pages and then go to Add New. Now, I'm just going to name this contact. To add the contact form, just go up to this little plus button, and then if we scroll down to Widgets and open this up, you will then see WP Forms. Just click on that and then we can just select the form from the drop down. While I'm here, I'm also going to add some heading text. I will just say contact me. Now just click on publish and then publish again. We have successfully added the contact form. It's doing very well on our website. Now I will show you how to test the new contact form. Take a fresh breath and follow my channel to support me. To send out a test email, we will enter our details and then click submit. Now we just have to check our email inbox. If you're like me, the email didn't show up in your inbox. What's happening is that the email is ending up in your spam folder, so we need to make sure to mark it as not spam. To do this, let's just go over to the spam folder. Click on spam and now you will see the email here. Simply just click on the email and on report not spam. Now it says that the conversation has been unmarked from spam and moved to the inbox. Let's just go back to our inbox and now the email shows up in our inbox. Any email that comes through that contact form will not be marked as spam anymore. If you want to respond to this email, simply click on the email and then you can write a response. If your test email wasn't successful and you cannot find it in your inbox or your spam folder, I will show you in this bonus part how to activate sending emails on WordPress using an SMTP server. SMTP, or Simple Mail Transfer Protocol, is the industry standard for sending emails, and since it uses proper authentication, it increases your email deliverability. Using an SMTP server keeps your emails from going to spam. To get things set up on your website, we'll be installing a plugin called WP Mail SMTP by WP Forms. As the name suggests, it comes from the same developer as the WP Forms contact form plugin we use. So let's click install now. Once you install it, you will also want to make sure you activate it. Once it's activated, you can go to WP Mail SMTP in your sidebar menu. Enter the from email. By default, your WP admin email address, which you assigned when setting up WordPress, is displayed here. It's the email address that WordPress uses to send emails. Make sure to enter the email address you will be using to send SMTP emails, which would be your email address associated with your Yahoo or Gmail account, for example. Then enter the field from name. This field will be displayed to your visitor as the sender when the email is received. I like to use Leonard at WP Staging to give it a personal touch. You can select false for both the email address and the name. This checkbox will apply the settings to the entire WordPress site, including other plugins. Activate the checkbox return path and you will get informed if there are issues with the recipient's email address. The selection of the mailer is the most important decision on this page. You can set up the SMTP server from one of the recommended mail services, or you can use your standard email provider. To set up SMTP using your standard email provider, click the other SMTP checkbox. You can get all of the required data from your hosting provider or email service. Otherwise, you can click on SMTP documentation. It will show you the details of the most popular providers. Enter smtp.example.com as the SMTP host. Select the encryption of your provider and make sure that the port is correct. For SSL encrypted connection, it's usually 465. Now add your SMTP username and password. For most providers, the SMTP username is simply your email address, and the SMTP password is the one you use to register the email. Now click on Save Settings and go to the Email Test tab to check whether all entries were correct and no problem occurred. If you like this new contact form, I am pleased about a thumbs up and a subscription to my channel. You won't miss any new videos from me, and your thumbs up will tell Google that this video ranked higher. Your help is much appreciated. Stay healthy. Greetings, Leonard.